Good morning, everyone. I'm Councilmember Robert Cornegie, Chair of the Committee on Housing and Buildings. We're here today to hold an oversight hearing on the housing lottery process. New York City is in the midst of an affordable housing crisis where many households pay more than half of their income towards rent. As a result, these households teeter on the brink of homelessness. Countless New Yorkers pin their hopes of receiving adequate and affordable housing on winning a housing lottery sponsored by the Department of Housing Preservation and Development. These housing lotteries provide applicants with the opportunity to secure housing with affordable rent, giving the ability to provide their families and keeping them from homelessness. Unfortunately, we heard from constituents that the housing lottery process is full of problems. Incomes are miscalculated in an error, excluding qualifying applicants for housing need they deserve. Applicants are frequently given conflicting information or told that their application documents that they kindly submit never received. Bills are consuming and often fruitless. We'll also hear six bills which seek to, among other things, bring clarity to an otherwise opaque process and ensure that the modest, the needy New Yorkers can find shelter. Councilmember Rosenthal, Intro 550, sponsored by Councilmember Levine, Intro 564, sponsored by Councilmember Traeger, and Intro 616, sponsored by Councilmember Whitman, Intro 11, sponsored by Councilmember Intro 11, of which I also am a sponsor, would provide that developers aside 15% of the available units for individuals and families. This legislation, I hope that New Yorkers are on equity. My fellow committee members, Councilmember Gradencik, Salamanca, Perkins, and Reynoso. We're going to at this point have an opening statement, Member Traeger, who is not present. We're sticking to a 2-minute clock for all public testimony. And now we'll administer the oath.
You have heard the whole testimony of the committee on the member questions.
And corresponding legislative package. I'm also joined today by Margaret Brown, Associate Commissioner for Housing, Alba Holm, Affordable Housing, responsibility is one of the priorities of Mayor. Our housing lottery process is a record, the city's vacancy rate remains low at 3.63%. Afford their rent. Love. 5 years into the plan, we have established a new housing can and should be built in New York. Already, this administration individuals making less than looking to speed apply for multiple homes. Now, 6 years after it was created, HPD is currently building our new approved housing transparent and user-friendly experience. 2.0 will automate applicants and HPD. Service providers, financial counseling experts, several types of housing implementation understand and address patterns of residency, public transit, and positive health outcomes, violence, and make the lottery selection process more efficient on expanding our existing and local, such as Impact Brooklyn, or the Mutual Housing, who help individuals prepare and apply for open lotteries. Mind, we appreciate the Council's shared goals to increase access to only. We want to keep in mind the ongoing is a core component of HPD's mission, and we are deeply in New York City. Also ensuring that these apartments may explain the process of building and preserving affordable housing in New York, anywhere else in the country. Losing even one financing source due to incompatible restraint finance. They outline eligible borrowers and sponsors, a critical way to structure we also continue feedback from in 2017, rental apartments, or SARA program, and 60% supportive housing homeless apartments, in the fact that we have increased housing production for both homeless New York City changes. In 2009, the last 2 years have seen changing federal regulations and a subsidiary meet the review processes. To make these efforts heard, information with law enforcement, New York State Department of projects that they work on are subject to greater projects, result in safe and lawful construction practices, and although we understand that interest in our project,
two of the
and stagnated wages. The most recent greatest city in the world. Strokes, if we have sponsors on this bill, and those on the brink of homelessness. Support I've received. Well, I have is on this because let us also not forget,
on behalf of going to keep
thank you so much of legislation. My bill, introduction 0564, to report on housing accepted, rejected, or put on a waiting list will also be available, is available for New Yorkers. Being more transparent
requires that developers procedures. Seminars that include issue that to issues related to credit and so forth and appeals process. And so forth. Should you receive money from extremely concerned about the burden, the financial burden of imposing, make sure the right way and that.
Thank you, sir. Per apartment. This is driven by online system. batteries are, and that it's consistent with the values that we want reflected. For example, process. These lotteries are administered by often for-profit third party. People are often informed that, of course, so many applicants.
Testimony, Commissioner Park. Paragraph.
Colleague who can speak more
specifically. So I just.
Okay. There are. About our homeless.
So in the lottery process, and so we do not track through the lottery. Although. We also do specifics that close. By household needs. Provide. To
a rate in the housing that we're building
in our asset management. We are introduction of Local Law 64, which initially goes. We will so
and HPD's term
project community facility goals labor low-cost retail. There to date, we have been
the mayor, and he's not HPD is doing in terms of their homeless set aside. But I want to get to my
percentage
of all units financed are the non-supportive housing.
Wrong number on the record.
Okay.
A percentage on the.